Rogers rises from indentures free. Strong his arm and keen his senses, he's a pirate now indeed.
Here's good luck to Frederic's ventures, Frederic's out of his indentures.
22 now he's rising, and alone he's fit to fly. Which we're bent on signalising with unusual rare high.
Here's good luck to Frederic's ventures, Frederic's out of his indentures.
From today, you rank as a full-blown member of our band.
Hey!
My friends, I thank you all from my heart for your kind wishes. Would that I could repay them as they deserve.
What do you mean?
Today I am out of my indentures, and today I leave you forever.
But this is quite unaccountable. A keener hand at scuttling a Cunarder or cutting out a piano never shipped a handspike.
Yes!
Yes, I have done my best for you. And why? Because it was my duty under my indentures. And I am the slave of duty. Oh. As a child, I was regularly apprenticed to your band. It was through an error. No matter, the mistake was ours and not yours. And I was in honor bound by it.
But an error? What error?
I may not tell you. It would reflect upon my well-loved Ruth.
Nay, dear master, my mind has long been gnawed by the cankering tooth of mystery. Better have it out at once. When Frederick was a little lad, he proved so brave and daring. His father thought he'd prentice him to some career seafaring. I was a lass, his nursery maid, and so it fell to my lot to take and bind the promising boy, apprentice to a pilot. A life not bad for a hardy lad, though surely not a high lot. Though I'm a nurse, you might do worse than make your boy a pilot. I was a stupid nursery maid on breakers, always steering, and I did not catch the word. Mistaking my instructions, which within my brain did gyrate, I took and bound this promising boy, apprentice to a pirate.
Oh!
Oh!
A sad mistake it was to make and doom him to a violet.
What?
I bound him to a pirate you instead of to a pilot.
Oh, Not the worst.
I soon found out beyond all doubt the scope of this disaster. But I hadn't the face to return to my place and break it to my master. A nursery maid is not afraid of what you people call work. I made up my mind to go as a kind of piratical maid of all work. And that is how you find me now, a member of your Shylock, which you wouldn't have found if he'd been bound apprentice to a pilot. Pardon, Frederick, pardon.
All right, sweet one. I have long since pardoned you.
The two words were so much alike.
Oh, they were. They still are, though years have rolled over their heads. But this afternoon, my obligation ceases. Individually, I love you all with affection unspeakable. But collectively, I look upon you with a disgust that amounts to absolute detestation. Oh, pity me, my beloved friends, for such is my sense of duty that once out of my indentures, I shall feel myself bound to devote myself, heart and soul, to your extermination.
Poor lad!
Frederic, if you conscientiously feel it's your duty to destroy us, well, we cannot blame you for acting upon that conviction. Always act in accordance with the dictates of your conscience, my boy, and chance the consequences.
Yes!
And besides, we can offer little temptation for you to remain here with us. We don't seem to make piracy pay.
Hey, well, I'm sure I don't know why, but we don't.
So, well, I know why, but alas, I mustn't tell you. It would not be right.
Why not? You see, according to the sun, it's only 11:30, and you are one of us until the... Jolly good, spiffing, thanks very much, 11:33. And you're one of us until the clock strikes 12.
Right.
True, and until then you are bound to protect our interests.
Well then, it is my duty as a pirate to tell you that you are too tender-hearted. For instance, you make it a point of never attacking a weaker party than yourselves. And when you attack a stronger one, you invariably get thrashed.
It's fair!
There is some truth in that.
Then again, you make it a point of never molesting an orphan.
Well, of course not. We are all orphans ourselves, and we know what it's like.
Ah, yes, but it's got about. And what is the consequence? Everyone we capture says he's an orphan. The last three ships we took proved to be manned entirely by orphans. We had to let them go. One would think Great Britain's mercantile navy was recruited solely from her orphan asylums, which we know is not the case.
Yes, but hang it all, you wouldn't have us absolutely merciless.
Well, there's my difficulty. Until 12 o'clock, I would. After 12, I wouldn't. Oh, was ever a man placed in so delicate a situation?
And Ruth, your own Ruth, whom you love so well, and who's won her middle-aged way into your boyish heart. What's to become of her?
Well, we thought we, Oh, yes, of course. Of course, if he must go, he can take you with him.
Yes!
Well, Ruth, I feel some little difficulty about you. It is true I admire you very much, but I have been constantly at sea since I was 8 years old, and yours is the only woman's face I've seen in that time. I think it is a sweet face.
It is! Oh, it is!
I say I think it is. That is my impression, but as I have never had the opportunity of comparing you with other women, it is just possible I may be mistaken.
Oh, that's true. At you!
Oh, what a terrible thing it would be if I were to marry this innocent person and then find out she's on the whole, you know, plain.
Oh! Ruth is very... well... yes, Ruth is very well indeed.
Indeed!
Well, yes, there are the remains of a fine woman about Ruth.
Do you really think so?
Oh, I do.
Well, then, I will not be so selfish as to take her from you. In justice to her and in consideration for you, I will leave her behind.
No! No, this cannot be. We are rough men.
Rough!
Yes, and we lead a rough life.
Rough!
But we are not so utterly heartless as to deprive thee of thy love. But I think I'm right in saying there is not one here that would rob thee of this inestimable treasure. For all the world holds dear.
Not one!
No, I told you there wasn't. Keep thy love, Frederick. Keep thy love.
Oh, you're very good, I'm sure.
Yes. Oh, yes. Oh, look, it's the top of the tide and we must be off. Frederick, farewell. When your process of extermination begins, let our deaths be as swift and painless as you could... as you can conveniently make them.
I will. By the love I have for you, I swear it. Would that you could render this extermination unnecessary by accompanying me back to civilization.
No, Frederick, no. I I don't think much of our profession, but contrasted with respectability. We are comparatively honest. No, Frederick, I shall live, and I shall die. Ah! A pirate king! Oh, better far to live and die under the brave black flag I fly. Then play a sanctimonious part with a pirate head and a pirate heart. So away to the cheating world go you. Go on away. Where pirates all are well-to-do. But I'll be true to the song I sing and live and die. Ah! A pirate. For I am a pirate king.
Hey! No!
And it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king. I am a pirate king.
You are a pirate king.
And it is a glorious thing to be a pirate. King. Sing!
Sing! We're up with a pirate.
Back in the barrel? I sink a few more ships, it's true that I will, but I'd rather not do.
Hey!
Whoa!
Hey!
Hey! Try doing that with a little white pointed stick, huh? But many a king on a first-class throne, if he wants to call his crown his own, must manage somehow to get through. More dirty work than No, please, no. I haven't finished yet. For I am a pirate king. Underwear. Pa. Ha ha ha. Get the boat ready. Pa. Ha ha ha.
Quite candid with you. You are very dear to me, as you know, but I must be circumspect. You see, you are considerably older than I, and a lad of 21 usually looks for a wife of 17.
17? You find me a wife of 1,000?
No, but I will find you a wife of 47, and that is quite enough. Oh, Ruth, tell me candidly and without reserve, compared with other women, how are you?
I will answer you truthfully, Master. I have a slight cold, but otherwise I'm quite well.
Well, I'm sorry if you're cold, but I was referring rather to your personal appearance. Compared with other women, are you beautiful?
I have been told so, dear Master.
Ah, lately?
No, years and years ago.
Well, what do you think of yourself, then?
It's a delicate question to answer, but I think I'm a fine woman.
And that is your candid opinion?
Oh, yes, I'd be deceiving you if I told you otherwise.
Oh, thank you, Ruth. I believe you, for I'm sure you would not practice on my inexperience. I wish to do the right thing. And if, I say, if you are a truly fine woman, then your age will be no obstacle to our union. Hark! Surely I hear voices. Who has ventured to approach our all but inaccessible lair? Can it be Custom House?
Yes!
No, it does not sound like Custom House.
Confusion, it is the voices of young girls. If he sees them, I am lost.
Oh, by all that's marvelous, a bevy of beautiful maidens.
Lost, lost, lost!
Oh, how lovely, how surpassingly lovely is the plainest of them. Oh, what grace, oh, what delicacy, oh, what refinement. And Ruth. Ruth told me she was beautiful. Oh, false one, you have deceived me.
I have deceived you.
Yes, deceived me. You told me you were fair as gold.
And master, am I not so?
And now I see you're plain and old.
I'm sure I'm not a jot so.
Upon my innocence you play.
I'm not the one to plot so.
Your face is lined, your hair is grey.
It gradually got so.
Faithless woman to deceive me, I who trusted so.
Master, master, do not leave me, hear me ere you go.
Faithless woman.
Master, master.
Faithless woman.
Master, master, do not leave me, do not leave me, hear me.
I who trusted so.
Master, master, do not leave me, hear me. Oh, do not be rejecting. and tender, her affection raw and green, at very highest rating has been accumulating summer 17. Don't be loved, master, crush me from disaster. What is such a dower to the dower I have here? My love unabating has been accumulating 47 years. 47 years.
Faithless woman to deceive me, I who trusted so.
Master, master, do not leave me.
I who trusted so.
What shall I do before these gentle maidens? I dare not show myself in this alarming costume. No, no, I must remain in close concealment until I can appear in decent clothing.
Let's go! picturesque spot. I wonder where we are.
And I wonder where Papa is. We have left him ever so far behind.
Oh, he'll be here presently. Remember, poor Papa's not as young as we are. And we have come over some rather difficult country. Cigarettes!
How very delightful it is to be so entirely alone. Why, in all probability, we are the first human beings ever to set foot on this enchanting spot.
Oh, except for the mermaids. It's the very place for mermaids.
We're only human beings down to the waist.
And who can't be said strictly to set foot anywhere. Tails they may, but feet they cannot.
Until Papa arrives.
Well, we are entirely alone. Oh, and the sea is as smooth as glass.
Perhaps we could take off our shoes. And stockings. And paddle.
Yes, yes, the very thing.
Stop, ladies, pray.
I had intended not to intrude myself upon your notice in this effective but alarming costume. But under these peculiar circumstances, I feel it is my bounden duty to inform you that your proceedings will not be unwitnessed.
But who are you, sir? Speak.
I am a pirate.
A pirate? Hurrah!
Ladies, do not shun me. This evening I renounce my vile profession. And to that end, O pure and peerless maidens, O blushing buds of ever-blooming beauty, I soar at heart, implore your kind assistance.
How pitiful his tale, how rare his beaut. How pitiful his tale, how rare his beauty.
One maiden breast which does not feel the moral beauty of making worldly interest subordinate to sense of duty. Who would not give up willingly all matrimonial ambition to rescue such a one as I from his unfortunate position, from his position to such a one as I from his unfortunate position.
Alas, there's not one maiden rest who seems to feel a moral beauty.
Thank you.
and not one maiden here, whose homely face and bad complexion have caused all hope to disappear of ever winning man's affection. To such a one, if such there be, I swear by heaven's arch above you, if you will cast your eyes on me, however plain you be, I love you, however plain you be. If you will cast your eyes on me, however plain you be, I
Donaldson.
Gentle sisters say, propriety we know, says we ought to stay. While sympathy exclaims, free them from their tether, play out our games, and leave them here together. Her case may any day be yours, my dear, or mine.
Let her make her hay
while the sun doth shine. Let us compromise, our hearts are not of leather. Let us shut our eyes and talk about the weather.
Yes, yes, let's talk about the weather.
How beautifully blue the sky, the glass is rising very high. Continue fine, I hope it may, and yet it rained. But yesterday, tomorrow, week before again, I hear the country wants some rain. People say, I know not why, that we shall have a warm July. Tomorrow, week before again, I hear the country wants some rain. People say, I know not why, that we shall have a warm July. Tomorrow, it may pour again, I hear the country wants some rain. People say, I know not why, that we shall have a warm July.
Beautifully blue the sky, the glass is rising very high. Continue fine, I hope it may, and yet it rained. But yesterday, tomorrow, it may pour again. I hear the country wants some rain. People say, I know not why, that we shall have a warm July. Tomorrow, it may pour again. I hear the country wants some rain. People say, I know not why, that we shall have a warm July. Tomorrow, it may pour again. I
did ever pirate roll his soul in gills he dreaming and wait to find his soul with peace and virtue beaming?
How
how beautifully blue the sky. The glass is rising very high. Continue fine, I hope it may, and yet it rained but yesterday. Continue fine, I hope it may, and yet it rained but yesterday.
Never fire and love will save a fool in his misery to find himself with love to lay.
We must not lose our senses. Men who stick at no offences will anon be here. Piracy their dreadful trade is. Pray you get you hence, young ladies, while the coast is clear.
No, we must not lose our senses. If they stick at no offences, we should not be here. Piracy their dreadful trade is. Nice companions for young ladies. Let us disarm.
Very well acquainted too with matters mathematical. I understand equations both the simple and quadratical. About my new theorem, I'm teeming with a lot of news. News. A lot of news. What rhymes with that? Oh, got one. With many cheerful facts about the square of the hypotenuse.
With many cheerful facts about the square of the hypotenuse. With many cheerful facts about the square of the hypotenuse. With many cheerful facts about the square of the hypotenuse.
I'm very good at integral and differential calculus. I know the scientific names of beings and animals. In short, it matters vegetable, animal, and mineral. I am the very model of a modern major general.
In short, it matters vegetable, animal, and mineral. He is the very model of a modern major general.
I know our mythic history, King Arthur's answer paradox. I answer hard acrostics, I have a pretty taste for paradox. I quote in elegiacs all the crimes of Heliogabalus. In chronics, I can floor peculiarities for errors. I can tell undoubted Raphael from Jerry Dowson's Ophanies. I know the croaking chorus from the frogs of Aristophanes. And I can hum a fugue of which I've heard the music's dinner for. Dinner for, dinner for. Got it! And a whistle all the airs from that infernal nonsense peanut
butter. And whistle all the airs from that infernal nonsense peanut butter. And whistle all the airs from that infernal nonsense peanut butter.
I can give projections on the Democrat and Greeny vote and tell Lloyd Webber's music from originals Puccini wrote. But still it matters vegetable, animal, and mineral. I am the very model of a modern major general.
But still it matters vegetable, animal, and mineral. He is the very model of a modern major general.
duffer.
What?
Oh, not you. Fellow with the apple in his head. Yes. Going up. In effect, when I know what is meant by Mamelon and Revelin. When I can tell at sight a Mauser rifle from a javelin. Oh, just kidding. When such affairs as Swarkies and surprises, I'm more wary. Where did they come from? Oh, there you are, my dear. Put those in some water, will you? Yes. And then wash your hands. And when I know precisely what is meant by commissariat.
Hey!
Oh, no, 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 no. It's a good word, commissariat. It means something witty. Yes, witty. As in half witty. When I have learned what progress has been made in modern gallery bang, when I know more of tactics than a novice in a nunnery, in a short, when I've a smattering of elemental strategy. Ooh, that's a hard rhyme. Anybody any ideas? What about you fellows down there in the cheap seats, yeah? No? Oh, I've got one. Here. Oh. You'd say a better major general has never sat at me. Rode a horse. Oh. My military knowledge, though I'm plucky and adventurous, has only been brought down to the beginning of the century. But still in matters vegetable, animal and mineral, I am the very model of a modern major general.
But still in matters vegetable, animal and mineral, he's the very model of a modern major general.
Yes.
Ah, yes. Very good.
Thank you very much.
Umbrellas on the chin and flowers. We like the medals too, don't we?
Yes. I got those on the front here.
Oh, really?
Yes, I had two on the back here, but they fell off.
Yes, well, never mind. Do some more, will you?
More? Silly man. There isn't any more.
No. We want some more. Make something up. Both of you.
Don't be ridiculous. Oh, steady on, steady on. Oh, goodness. Rather feisty fellow. Something ridiculous for the fellow in the purple pants.
What tempo would you like it, sir?
Tempo?
Yes.
I think we'd better do it quickly.
Could we have an Italian, please?
Italian?
Yes.
Espresso cappuccino. I am the very model of a modern major general. I've information seminal and cultural and federal and regional and functional and fictional and textural. Abominable. Abdominable. I can't say that word. Terrible. Scriptural, confessional, and sexual. Sorry, slipped out. Get away from my daughter, will you? That sort of thing around here, disgusting. Impeccable, improbable, oh, deplorable, debatable. Settle down, that's enough of that. Unpleasant, undemanding, unimportant, untranslatable. Yes. Imponderable, mystical, ballistical and a germinal. Oh, in effect so bloody boring that it's positively terminal.
In effect so bloody boring that it's positively terminal. In effect so bloody boring that it's positively terminal. In effect so bloody boring that it's positively terminal.
So let's conclude this larrikin commercial Mardi Gras quick, or I'll be singing this song till Australia's a republic.
Hey!
With a dash of bitters or some tonic in your general, I am the very bottle of a Perrier that's mineral.
What?
I'm a little ahead of my time. Why don't we rewind a bit?
But the steel in matters vegetable, animal and mineral. I am the very model of a modern major general.
The steel in matters vegetable, animal and mineral. What's the very model of a modern major general?
And now that I've introduced myself, I should like to have some idea of what's going on.
I'll explain in two words. We propose to marry your daughters.
Dear me!
Against our wills, Papa! Against our wills!
Yes, I bet. Well, you mustn't do that. May I ask? This is a very picturesque uniform. Gorgeous. Yes. But I'm not familiar with it. What are you? A bunch of thespians?
Beg your pardon?
Are you or any of your bunch thespians?
Church of England.
Yes.
Then single gentleman, what?
Yes.
Yes, yes, I gathered that. Anything else?
No, nothing else.
Don't believe him, Papa.
What?
They're pirates. The famous pirates of Penzance.
Hooray!
Thank you, my dear. The pirates of Penzance.
Hooray!
Remind me not to say that again.
What's that?
The pirates of Penzance.
Hooray!
Give myself a cardiac. Yes, I've often heard of them.
All except for this gentleman, who was a pirate once, but who is out of his indentures today and who means to lead a blameless life evermore.
Wait a bit. Yeah, put your thingy down. So, you're pirates. And you're unemployed. That's a toss-up. Well, I object to pirates as sons-in-law.
Well, we object to major generals as mothers-in-law.
Yes.
But we are prepared to waive that point. You know, we don't press it, you understand? We look over it.
Ah, an idea. And do you mean to say that you would deliberately rob me of these, the sole remaining drops of my old age, and leave me to go through the remainder of my life unfriended, unprotected, and alone?
Yes, that's the idea.
Kill me! Have you ever known what it is to be an orphan? I ask you, have you ever known what it is to be an orphan?
Orphan?
Yes, orphan. Have you ever known what it is to be one?
Yes, I say, orphan!
Orphan! Orphan! Orphan!
No, excuse me. I don't think we quite understand one another. I ask you, have you ever known what it is? Have you ever known what it is to be an orphan? And you say orphan.
Yes?
Now, as I understand you, you are merely repeating the word orphan to show that you understand me.
I didn't repeat the word orphan.
I'm sorry, you did indeed.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did. I heard you distinctly.
Well, you heard wrong. I didn't.
No, I didn't, and you did.
Don't be childish. I didn't.
I am not being childish. You did.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
Did
infinity.
No, I didn't.
gift. Very well, then. You didn't.
I only repeated it once.
Yes, but you repeated it.
And yes, but not often. Stop!
I think I see where we're getting confused. When you say orphan, do you mean orphan a person who has lost his parents? Or orphan frequently?
Oh!
Yeah, see? Frequently.
Oh! I beg your pardon. I see what you mean. Yes, often, frequently.
So you see it often frequently?
No, only once.
Exactly. You said often frequently only once.
Kill him.
O men of dark and dismal fate, forgo your cruel employ. Have pity on my lonely state. I am an orphan boy.
An orphan boy.
An orphan boy.
How sad, an orphan boy.
These children whom you see are all that I can call my own.
Oh, fellow.
Take them away from me, and I shall be indeed alone.
Poor fellow.
If pity you can feel, leave me my soul remaining joy. See at your feet they kneel.
Get down.
Your hearts you cannot steal against the sad, sad tale of a lonely orphan boy.
Orphan boy, the orphan boy, the orphan boy.
Orphan.
I'm telling a terrible story, but it doesn't diminish my glory, for they would have taken my daughters over the billowy waters. If I hadn't an elegant diction, indulged in an innocent fiction, which is not in the same category as telling a regular terrible story.
He's telling a terrible story, which would diminish his glory, because they would have taken his daughters over the billowy waters. There is easy and elegant diction to call it an innocent fiction, but it comes in the same category as telling a regular terrible story. It's easy and elegant diction to call it an innocent fiction, but it comes in the same category as telling a regular story.
Although our dark toil sometimes involves the crime of that we're not all together void of feeling. Although we live by strife, we're always sorry to begin it. For what we ask is life without a touch of poetry.
Finished yet?
You may go, for you are at liberty. Our pirate rules protect you. An honorary member of our band, we do elect you.
Sometimes it's a useful thing to be an orphan boy.
It is a lovely orphan boy, an orphan boy.
Do you want?
no. No!
Reconcile it with your conscience to say something that will relieve my father's sorrow.
I will try, dear Mabel. But why does he sit here night after night in this drafty old ruin?
Why do I sit here? To escape from the pirate's clutches. I described myself as an orphan. And heaven help me, I am no orphan. I come here to humble myself before the tombs of my ancestors and to implore their pardon. Ha ha. For having brought dishonor on the family escutcheon. Oh,
but you forget, sir, you only bought the property a year ago, and the stucco on your baronial castle is scarcely dry.
Frederic, in this chapel are ancestors. You cannot deny that. With the estate, I bought the chapel and its contents. I do not know whose ancestors they were, but I know whose ancestors they are. And I shudder to think that their descendant, by purchase, if I may so describe myself, should have brought disgrace upon what I have no doubt was an unstained escutcheon.
Oh, be comforted. Be comforted. Oh, for God's sake, be comforted. Had you not acted as you did, those reckless men would have assuredly called in the nearest clergyman and married your family on the spot.
I thank you for your proffered solace, but it is unavailing. I assure you, Frederick, that such is the anguish and remorse I feel at the abominable... At the abominable... Such is the anguish and remorse I feel at the abominable...
Snowman?
No! The abominable...
Falsehood.
Yes, falsehood. Thank you, Frederick. By which I escaped these easily deluded pirates, that I would go to their tall, simple-minded, gallivanting, purple-painted, yet strangely attractive. Chief, this very night, and confess all! Did I not fear that the consequences would be... That the consequences would be... Most disastrous to myself. At what time does your expedition march against these scoundrels?
At 11, and before midnight, I hope to have atoned for my involuntary association with the pestilent scourges by sweeping them from the face of the earth.
Oh.
And then, dear Mabel, you will be mine.
And are your devoted followers at hand?
They are. They only await my orders.
Then, Frederick, let your escort, Lionhearted, be summoned to receive a general's blessing ere they depart upon their dread adventure.
Dear sir, they come.
Dare to steal. I would uncomfortable feel. And we find the wisest thing. It's to slap our chests and sing tarantara. For when threatened with a mute. And you're hafted in your boots.
There is nothing brings it round like the trumpet's muffled sound, like the trumpet's muffled sound. Ta-ren-ta-ra, 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 ra, 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 ta-ren-ta-ra, ta-ren-ta-ra, ta-ren-ta-ra.
Now for the pirate's lair, all joy unbounded, oh sweet relief, oh rapture unexampled, at last I may atone in some slight measure for the repeated acts of theft and pillage at which had a sense of duty's stern dictation. I, circumstance's victim, have been guilty.
Young Frederick.
Who calls?
Your late commander.
And I, your little Ruth.
Oh, mad intruders, how dare ye face me? Know ye not, oh rash ones, that I have doomed you to extermination?
Oh, don't be silly.
Have mercy on us. Hear us ere you slaughter.
I do not think I ought to listen to you.
Wait.
Yet mercy should alloy our stern resentment. And so I will be merciful. Say on.
No. When you had left our pirate fold, we tried to lift our spirits faint, according to our custom old, with quips and quibbles quaint. But all in vain the quips we heard, we lay and sobbed upon the rocks, until to somebody occurred a startling paradox.
A paradox.
A paradox.
A most ingenious paradox, with quips and quibbles heard in flocks, none to beat that paradox.
A paradox, a paradox, a most ingenious paradox. This paradox.
We knew your taste for curious quips, for pranks and contradictions queer, and with the laughter on our lips we wished you there to hear. We said if we could tell it him, how Frederic would the joke enjoy. And so we risked both life and limb to tell it to our boy.
That paradox.
That paradox.
That most ingenious paradox, with quips and quibbles heard in flocks, none to beat this paradox.
A paradox, a paradox, a most ingenious paradox. This paradox.
This way. You ready, Freddy?
Yes.
It's a good one. Right. For some ridiculous reason, to which, however, I have no desire to be disloyal, some person in authority, I don't know who, very likely the Astronomer Royal, has decided that, although for such a beastly month as February, 28 days as a rule are plenty. That is 1 year in every four, when his days shall be reckoned as 9 and 20. And through some singular coincidence, I shouldn't be surprised if it were owing to the agency of an ill-natured fairy. You are the victim of this clumsy arrangement, having been born in leap year on the 29th of February. And so, by a simple arithmetical process, you will easily discover. Ho, this is the good bit. Stop me if you heard it before. Though you've lived for 21 years, yet, if you go by birthdays, you're only 5. And a little bit over.
Hear me, let's see. Yes, yes, with yours my figures do agree. How quaint the ways of paradox that common sense she gaily mocks. Though counting in the usual way, years 21 I've been alive.
Right.
And yet, right, reckoning by my natal day,
mm-hmm,
yet reckoning by my natal day. 1, 2, 3, 4. I am a little boy of 5.
He is a little boy of 5. I told you so.
A paradox, a paradox, a most ingenious paradox. This paradox. A curious paradox. A most ingenious paradox.
Oh, upon my word. This is most curious, most absurdly whimsical. 5 1/4, eh? Oh, you wouldn't think it to look at me.
I'm glad now I'll be bound haven't you spared us? You never would have forgiven yourself when you discovered you'd killed two of your comrades.
Oh, yes.
My comrades?
Yes, I'm afraid you don't appreciate the delicacy of your position, Frederick. You see, you were apprenticed to us.
Until I reached my 21st year.
Ah, no, not quite. You were apprenticed to us until you reached your 21st. Dear Pirate King, I love your purple pants. Meet me later.
No! That's the wrong one!
You apprenticed to us until you reached your 21st birthday. Yes, and going by birthdays, you are as yet only 5 1/4. Oh,
you don't mean to say you're going to hold me to that?
Yes. We merely remind you of the fact and leave the rest to your sense of duty.
Your sense of duty? Oh.
Don't put it on that footing. Oh, as I was merciful to you just now, be merciful to me.
Oh, no. Oh,
I implore you not to insist upon the letter of your bond, just as the cup of happiness is at my lips.
We insist on nothing. We content ourselves with merely pointing out to you your duty.
Yes. No, Tony. Do you understand?
I think I do. With vigor unshaken, the step shall be taken.
Very neatly planned.
I think so too.
We'll readily bet it, you'll never regret it.
For duty must be done. The rule applies to everyone. And painful though that duty be, to shirk the task for fiddly-dee, to shirk the task for fiddly-dee, to shirk the task, to shirk the task for fiddly-fiddly-fiddly-fiddly-fiddly-fiddly-fiddly-fiddly-dee.
Woo-hoo! Oh. Anyway. I did it.
Are we? I'm not.
And that was all.
It's just to inspire the prodigal pirate.
I'm glad I think and walking tall. Well, just a bit scary.
In the bag of sherry.
Cause duty must be done. The rule applies to everyone. And painful though that duty be, to shirk the task for fiddly-dee, to shirk the task for fiddly-dee, to shirk the task, to shirk the task for fiddly-dee.
A blue-eyed boy is back and simply brimming with glee over joining the trio.
In your employ,
we're setting sail tonight.
And our booty's a slave to his duty.
For duty must be done. The rule applies to everyone. And painful though that duty be, to shirk the task for fiddly-dee, to shirk the task for fiddly-dee, to shirk the task, to shirk the task of fiddly-fiddly-fiddly-fiddly-fiddly-fiddly-fiddly-dee.
All right.
Well, you have appealed to my sense of duty, and my duty is only too clear. Oh, I abhor your infamous calling. Oh, I shudder at the thought I've ever been mixed up
We've
with it.
We've got him.
And yet, duty is before all. And at any price, I will do my duty.
Bravely spoken, Frederick. Come. You are one of us once more. Away.
Oh, lead on. I follow. Oh, horror!
What's
the matter?
What'd I tell you? No, I mustn't. And yet, as one of your band...
Frederick, speak out! I charge you by the sense of conscientiousness to which we have never yet appealed in vain. I just, it's a bit sort of bogged down with plot there, so I sort of colour and movement, you know. What? Sorry?
They wanted to go.
Oh, well, okay.
General Stanley.
Yes?
The father of my Mabel.
Yes?
General Stanley escaped from you on the plea that he was an orphan.
He did?
Yes, you were there.
Oh, yes, and he... Right, and he... That's right, yes, yes. Well?
Oh, it breaks my heart to betray the honored father of the girl that I adore.
Break it.
Yes.
And yet, as one of your band, I have no alternative.
No.
It is my duty to tell you...
Yes,
that... General Stanley...
Yes.
Is?
Is.
No?
No.
General Stanley.
Yes.
Is. Yes. No.
No.
Ooh. Oh! Oh! Orphan!
What?
Well, it's better than me.
Oh!
When you say orphan...
Oh!
Do you mean a person who has lost his parents or orphan frequently?
A person who has lost his parents.
What?
And more than that, he never was one.
Hold that. Frederic, am I to understand? Ouch. That in order to save his contemptible life, he dared to practice an acredulous simplicity? Then our revenge shall be swift and
kind.
No.
Merciful.
No. Swift and, you know, abominable.
Oh, well done.
Collect our band, not you. An attack from Modern Castle, it's many nights!
But stay!
Not a word! He is doomed!
Away, my heart's on fire, I burn this base deception to repay. This very night, my vengeance sire will glut itself and go!
Away, I expire, I find my duty hard to do today. My heart is filled with anguish dire. It strikes me to the core, away.
With force and foul, he tricked us of our pride. And vengeance howl, the pilot so decide. A nature stern, he softened with his lies. And in return, tonight the traitor dies.
Yes, tonight the traitor dies. Yes, tonight the traitor dies. Tonight he
sort early tomorrow.
His girls likewise.
They were welter in sorrow.
The ones so smart.
In the nature they cherish.
And all who plot.
To others it shall perish.
Tonight he dies so early tomorrow. His girls likewise, they were welter in sorrow. The ones so smart in their natures they cherish. And all who plot to others it shall perish. Away, away, away. Tonight the traitor dies. Away, away tonight.
Terrible disclosure has just been made. Mabel, my dearly loved one, I bound myself to serve the pirate captain until I reached my 21st birthday.
But you are 21.
I've just discovered that I was born in leap year, and that birthday will not be reached by me till 1940.
Oh, horrible catastrophe, appalling.
And so I quit these walls. The thought my soul appalls. But when stern duty calls, I must obey.
Stay,
Mabel, stay. Nay, Mabel, nay.
They have no
claim. But duty's name, the thought my soul appalls. But when stern duty calls, I must obey.
Seemed fair as mine.
must I leave thee here in endless night to dream, where joy is dark and drear and sorrow supreme, where nature day by day will sing in altered tone this weary roundelay. He loves thee, he is gone. La 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 la. In 1940, I of age shall be. I'll then return and claim you, I declare it.
It seems so long.
Swear that till then, you will be true to me. Here is love, and here is true, and here is good, the joyous laughter. She will be faithful to her suit, till we are wed, and even after. Oh, here is love, and here is true. She will be faithful to her suit, till we are wed, and even after. And even after.
Yes, even after.
Oh, here is love, and here is true, and here is food for joyous laughter. She will be faithful to her suit. She will be faithful to her suit till we are wed, and even after, even after.
Oh, here is love,
and here is truth. Oh, here is love, here's love.
Body and in mind.
Tarantara, tarantara.
Oh, we are timidly inclined.
Tarantara. and anything but blind.
Tarantara, tarantara.
To the danger that's behind.
Tarantara.
Yet when the danger's near.
Tarantara, tarantara.
We manage to appear.
Tarantara.
As insensible to fear as anybody here. As anybody here. Tarantara, tarantara. Rock, 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 rock. Tarantara, ra, 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 tarantara, tarantara, tarantara.
Sergeant, approach. Young Frederick was to have led you to death and glory.
That is not a pleasant way of putting it.
Quite right.
No matter, he will not so lead you, for he has once more allied himself with his old associates.
He has acted shamefully.
Yes.
You speak falsely. You know nothing about it. He has acted nobly.
He has acted nobly.
Before, his heroic sacrifice to his sense of duty has endeared him to me tenfold. He has done his duty. I will do mine. Go ye and do yours.
Right on.
This is perplexing.
You can say that again.
This is perplexing.
You can say that.
No matter, boys. Our course is clear. We must do our best to capture these pirates.
Rah!
Alone. It is most distressing to us to be the agents whereby our erring fellow creatures are deprived of that liberty which is so dear to us all. But we should have thought of that before we joined the force.
We should.
Well, it's too late now.
Give it.
Look.
Oh.
When a felon's not engaged in his employment,
his employment,
or maturing his felonious little plan,
little plans,
his capacity for innocent enjoyment,
innocent enjoyment,
is just as great as any honest man.
Honest man's.
Our feelings we with difficulty smother,
difficulty smother,
when constabulary duties to be done,
to be done,
I take one consideration with another,
with another.
A policeman's lot is not a happy one. When constabulary duties to be done, a policeman's lot is not a happy one. Happy one. When the enterprising burglar's not a burgling,
not a burgling,
when the cutthroat isn't occupied in crime,
crime,
he loves to hear that little brook a-gurgling,
brook a-gurgling,
and listen to the merry village chime, when the constantine is jumping on his mother,
on his mother.
Oh, he loves to lie a-basking in the sun,
in the sun.
Oh, take one consideration with another,
with another.
A policeman's lot is not a happy one. When constabulary duties to be done, a policeman's lot is not a happy one.
A happy one.
With stealthy steps, the pirates are approaching!
How are we going
to do they seek a penalty. 50 bold, they seek a penalty. 50 bold, the General Stanley story.
There's the door.
They come. They come in force with stealthy stride. Our obvious course is now to hide. Quick.
Frederic!
I can't whistle.
Very quietly. Let's go! It wasn't me, it was one of the musicians.
Which musician?
Oh, no, it wasn't a musician, it was a drummer, sorry.
Yeah.
Gallaher, please. This is very important. Please, this is... We haven't finished yet. Some very important dialogue to do. We haven't finished yet. Away.
Hush, hush. Not a word. I see a light inside.
Yeah, the light's great.
The Major General comes. So quickly hide.
Yes, yes, the Major General comes.
Yes, yes, the Major General comes. What's going on? Oh! Tormented with the anguish dread of falsehood unatoned, I lay upon my sleepless bed and tossed and turned and groaned. The man who finds his conscience ache, no peace at all enjoys. And as I lay in bed, awake, I thought I heard a noise.
He thought he heard a noise.
Ah-ha! No. All is still in dale on hill. My mind is set at ease. So still the scene, it must have been, the sighing of the breeze. Sighing softly to the river comes the laughing breeze, setting rustling through the trees.
Through the trees!
And the brook in rippling measure lasts for very long, while the poplars in their pleasure wave their arms above.
Yes, the trees for very long wave their leafy arms above. River, river, may thy whooping happy be. Heaven sleep the poplar tree. May thy whooping happy be.
Yet the breeze is but a rover when he wings away. Brook and poplar mourn a lover, sighing well-a-day.
Well-a-day!
Ah, the doing and undoing that the rogue could tell. When the breeze is out a-wooing, who can woo so well?
Thy dream is over, for thy love is but a rover. Sad the lot of poplar trees, courted by a fickle breeze.
There's a lot of poplar trees courted by a fiddle breeze.
Now what is this and what is that and why does father leave his letter? Such a time of night as this, so very incomplete, defective father is and always was the most pathetic colour man. Is it very humble room to go to bed at half past ten? What strange occurrence can it be that caught him father from his rest? Such a time of night as this, so very incompletely dressed. So very incompletely dressed. At such a time of night.
She's a great general now.
Your life is over.
Treason! Summon your men and effect their capture.
Beautiful Mabel, I would if I could, but I am not able.
He's telling the truth, he is not able.
We've faced a siege, you act upon our feelings. Revenge is sweet. And flavors all our dealings. With courage rare and resolution manly. For death prepare, unhappy General Stanley.
yes, yes, with all their faults, they love the Queen. Yes, yes, with all their faults, they love the Queen.
Away with them and place them at the bar.
One moment. Let me tell you who they are. These are no members of the common throng. These are all noblemen who have gone wrong.
They are all noblemen who have gone wrong.
No Englishman unmoved that statement hears. Because with all our faults, we love our House of Peers. Come with me, my dear. I pray you pardon me, ex-pirate king. Peers will be peers.
What?
What? What? Yes. And youth will have its fling. Go on, have a fling. Go on. Resume your ranks. I'm so glad you're not thespians. And take my daughters, all of whom are Presbyterians. Hey!
Thank you.
merry duties to be done, to be done. A policeman's lot is not a happy one.
Find me now, a member of your shy lot, which you wouldn't have found, if he'd been found. That pirate, silly pirate!
In shorting matches, venture triple, animal and mineral, I am the very model of a modern region general.
I'm a warrior king, I'm a pirate king.